My name is John Boehmer. I'm a professor of medicine and surgery at Penn State College of Medicine. We're looking at ways of preventing rehospitalization following an admission for heart failure. That's a major problem because in excess of 20% of patients are readmitted within 30 days and in excess of 40% by 90 days. The main reason they're readmitted is for another diagnosis of heart failure. So we need a better way of managing those patients during a high-risk period for heart failure hospitalization. So Microcor is a small adhesive patch. It's a wearable device that uses low energy, radio frequency energy, in order to get a measure of lung fluid content. By doing that and combining it with data on heart rate and respirations, it's able to provide information to clinicians, which is then actionable. Benefits of Microcor in acute decompensated heart failure trial is a two-arm concurrent control clinical trial. It's not a randomized controlled trial, but had two arms, an intervention arm and an observation arm, going on concurrently. We then compared the results for heart failure hospitalization between those two arms. So the intervention arm, where clinicians were able to see the data as well as the patients able to see the data, and the clinicians were able to act on it, there was a 38% relative risk reduction in the risk of a heart failure hospitalization. When we looked at the risk of a combined event of heart failure hospitalization, emergency department visit, or death, that was also reduced by 38%. That is a 7% of patients total who would have had a heart failure hospitalization did not as a result of this intervention, or a number needed to treat of 14. Well, we hope that this will be a new tool that you will have for heart failure patients. And one of the good things about it is it's a wearable device. It's not a long-term device that's implanted and goes on and on. This is just for the period of time where their patients are at increased risk, meaning that once the patient is beyond that period of risk, you can utilize it on a different patient. So we hope that this will be utilized in practice now and will be another tool that we have to monitor patients through a high-risk period. And further analyses are coming to help us understand exactly how this works and exactly what interventions work best. So the next step is going to be delving into the database more, looking at what interventions were made by practitioners, and then seeing which interventions had the most impact on reducing heart failure hospitalizations, and then coming up with the best practices based on those findings.